Welcome to the fifth part in a series of videos dealing with the question, did the Apostle Paul teach a return of the Lord that was prophesied in the scriptures of the Old Testament, or did he introduce another return? The passage we are looking at is in 1 Thessalonians, where Paul wrote, "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first." In the first four parts of this series, we looked at the first sentence in this verse, "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God." We have seen that Paul was referring to multiple prophecies in the scriptures about the return of the Lord. Let's now look at the next sentence, "and the dead in Christ will rise first." In context, Paul is saying that when Jesus descends from heaven, those who belonged to the Lord when they died will be resurrected. The question is, was Paul referring to a prophecy in the scriptures? Yes, it's almost certain he had a passage in Isaiah 26 in mind, where it says, "Your dead shall live, together with my dead body they shall arise." When we look at this verse in context, we see that Isaiah is referring here to the dead who belong to the Lord. And he is saying that the dead who belong to the Lord will live, they are going to arise, in other words, be resurrected. The context of this verse also indicates when the resurrection of those who belong to the Lord will happen. Two verses later, we read, "For," which means because, thus pointing back to what has just been written, "Behold, the Lord comes out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity." Therefore, we understand that the resurrection of those who belong to the Lord will happen when the Lord comes out of his place, which is heaven. Paul said the same when he stated, "The Lord himself will descend from heaven," and then wrote, "And the dead in Christ will rise." When we consider the verse in Isaiah we just looked at, we see that when the Lord comes, at which time the resurrection of those who belong to him will happen, he will punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. This aligns with what Paul stated in 2 Thessalonians, where he wrote that the Lord Jesus will be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels in flaming fire, taking vengeance on those who do not know God. These shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power when he comes in that day to be glorified in his saints. We see from what Paul writes that on the day the Lord comes with his angels in flaming fire, he will be glorified in all those who belong to him, including the dead among them who are resurrected, and he will punish the ungodly. This is clear when we correlate what Paul wrote here with what he wrote in 1 Thessalonians 4. "For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first." The Apostle Paul evidently wrote what he did because he was very much aware of the prophecies of the mighty coming of the Lord described in the scriptures, at which time the Lord will resurrect the dead who belong to him.